For surfers, the spirit of adventure urges many of us to pack our bags and head out in search of the unknown, the unexpected, and everything we could dream of. This passion of discovery has drawn us to the Central American country of Panama, where the coastline features a variety of long beaches, rocky coves, bays, and points. The crew is a mix of backgrounds and talent. Magnum Martinez is from Venezuela, but after bouncing around Central America for many years with his wife, has decided to plant his feet in Panama.
I don't know why we even thought about it. We got good friends here, and this place has a huge variety of surf breaks, and I think it's a part of the geography that it's not really like a straight coast. It kind of goes up, then it comes down, and then there's this big peninsula that I was.
It's a pleasure to live down here. I mean, you're a few hour flight from Nicaragua, you're a few hours from Ecuador, you're only 6 from LA. You're not disconnected at all. You're very connected, and it's really accessible to everything here for us.
From Florida, Sterling Spencer has been on many trips throughout Central America. But this trip to Panama was a first for Sterling, who was eager to sample the waves.
I've been to Costa, Nicaragua probably like 10 times, and I've never wandered to Panama.
The groms of the trip were California's Jake Davis and Griffin Colapinto. These two were in Panama competing at a World Junior Surfing event and decided to extend their trip and join the crew in search of more Panamanian stoke. Local guide Richy Arosemena has been pioneering the many surf breaks around Panama for the last 25 years and continually boasted of Panama's diverse surf potential.
Many of my friends consider me one of the going to discover places, you know, new places like this. This side of the province of Los Santos, Cambutal. Our surfing community was really small, you know. Then I decided to check up some spots, looking at the maps, and discover some waves. But I guess some spots it remains to discover because the different tide, the different direction of swell. We have wave for any kind of level of surfing. Challenge wave, very powerful waves, till, you know, mushy and slow and easy waves. We have two oceans very close to each other, less crowded. As I told you, there's a lot of waves to discover over here, so that will be a challenge stuff for surfers to come over here.
With a network of country roads leading to each next location, Panama was poised to deliver adventure. When we return, the crew hits the water for the first surf of the trip. We'll be right back. Welcome back. After starting out at Playa Venao, one of Panama's better known beach breaks, the crew was eager to see what other waves the coast had to offer. The region of Cambutal lies a few hours from Venao and hosts a variety of points, coves, reefs, and beaches. Now living in Panama, Magnum Martinez seems to have it dialed.
We're sitting on a peninsula that it's pretty huge, you know, and then obviously on the east side there's hardly any waves, but then finally comes closer to the city where, you know, faces south a little more, and then when you get big swells you got surf like within 50 minutes of the city. So now we're down here in a peninsula that's really facing south, southwest, so it's really susceptible to any type of swell, and the swell is kind of medium smallish, so we still get surf overhead waves right here, and I just love that whole like variety of spots that we have here, and that, you know, the bottoms changes from sand and been out here, it's like more slabby rock breaks, and then you can go around the corner and be some amazing beach breaks, sand bottom again, and in the Caribbean it's all reef, you know, so that creates different type of surf, hollow, like fun, mushy, whatever, however you want. There's type of waves here for any taste and like.
Eager to surf, the Groms couldn't help heading out to the first spot they saw. A small tip of rocky reef that seemed to be sucking in some swell. Deciding to continue down the road, Richy guided the crew to a secluded cove he dubbed Cuarto Circuito, or Short Circuit. The cove curved out into a cliff point with a couple of reef sections on the outside. Although the spot can get better on bigger swells, with empty lines pushing through, the crew is eager to get on it. crew also ventured down the beach to find a few more empty spots that held loads of potential. Once you get out of the water in Panama, there is plenty of beauty and culture to soak up. With an abundance of fresh, tasty food and clean, drinkable well water in the country towns, there's very little to worry about. The Panamanians are a friendly bunch and eager to share their corner of the world with everyone.
The key over here is we are so few people. Many towns are small, people know each other. We got food, we got jobs. So people is not like starving or stuff like that. People is just friendly to everyone that comes because we like to share our land with everybody, our ways, our culture. And the Americans came here to make the canal, and before that the French come. We're accustomed to the people that come. Different people from the different countries come to live here, to travel here. That's why we're friendly with all the people. We're accustomed to people to come here.
I think the most important thing is to respect the locals. The locals are really friendly. Just come and have a good time, enjoy, be respectful, and I'm sure you're gonna have a beautiful time here.
With the new swell filling in, the group is back on the road once again in search of more surf. And with Magnum and Richy feeling optimistic about a secret beach break dishing up some offshore barrels, everyone was on board. When we come back, the crew trekked to the coast in hopes of finding a slice of beach break perfection all to themselves. Stick around for more Panamanian surf action. Welcome back to the show. With an expanse of twisting, turning coastline, getting to the best surf spots isn't always easy. And while the traffic on the country roads is never an issue, the potholes can be a force to be reckoned with. Nonetheless, the scenery of the countryside put the crew at ease, as well as the thought of scoring empty barrels to themselves.
It's got its challenges, and this place is really unexplored. It's a lot less crowded, and you know, you can understand why. Like, it's more inaccessible, like, in a way. It's a little more difficult to get to spots. You gotta drive, you gotta hire a boat and whatnot, so it makes it a little different, but at the same time, the coastline offers a lot of different options, and I like the fact that it's unexplored and you can go try to find your own spot, you know?
Hearing the ocean rumble beyond the trees, the excitement was mounting. But there was one last hurdle before getting there.
We were driving, we went down this dirt road, we walked across the sketchiest bridge ever.
It was made out of sticks, and I thought I was gonna fall in, so it was pretty sketchy. And then we pulled up, we walk out, and we see perfect barrels just going unridden, no one out.
Yeah, we'll probably surf this peak on the high tide to medium, and then the peak down a little bit to the north of the beach will be probably on the lower tide. So wind's looking good offshore. It's kind of late in the season to get this wind, so take it as a blessing.
Let me tell you about it. dreams that are gone true. It's a certain shame with reggae and they drum it through and through. And the bass and guitar rhythm that's coming back at you. When I think about all my future, I think about what to do. I wanna grow up in the reggae band.
We had a really fun session this morning. Thank God and Mother Nature, we had some really good offshore winds and the conditions were beautiful. The water color was really nice.
Yeah, it was mostly barrels today. The barrels were like prime. The rain was really good. It was offshore, so perfect conditions for the barrels.
The waves were really good. This is how I thought Panama would be, and we scored. It was offshore, perfect rights and lefts, and there were a couple really good ones.
While everyone scored, Sterling got some of the best tubes of the day. Living so close in Florida, he couldn't believe he never made the short trip to Panama before.
Traveling here is really easy. It's basically one flight to Florida. I just never known anyone that's lived here or anyone that goes here, but I've always heard the waves get really good. The wave today was amazing.
Waves weren't big or anything, but it was just, you know, fun enough and big enough for it to be like a few barrels and a few turns and all this stuff. And I think the boys enjoy themselves and I enjoy myself, I know that.
Coming up next, more beach break action from somewhere in Panama. Don't go anywhere.
Where are we? We're in Panama, somewhere in Panama. If that's kind of like a cliche nowadays, somewhere in Panama. That's where we are. Enjoy it. It's beautiful.
At the secluded beach, the crew had the lineup all to themselves. But after a 5-hour morning session, it was time for a break.
We are in beautiful Panama.
A jungle.
We have tuna, little canned tuna that we bring down. Bring some bread down and we scavenge coconuts and we break those open.
Oh my gosh, that coconut is so good right there.
Coconut hunting. They run. They're hard to get.
With the tide filling in and recharged with coconut water, it was back out for the afternoon sesh. Crew went back the next day in hopes of more surf. While it wasn't quite as hollow, it was still rippable and the boys were back on it.
Yeah.
swell started to drop and the wind picking up, it was time to pack it in and hit the road once more. This time the crew headed inland in search of a different kind of adrenaline rush. High in the tropical forest, they found more water, but this time from a different perspective. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, the boys gear up for a zipline rush through the Panamanian rainforest. Keep it right here. Welcome back. High in Panama's jungle forest, our crew is about to experience the rainforest from above. Partaking in one of the many canopy zipline tours, the boys harnessed up and hit the trail. After the first few runs, the nerves were all shaken out and the goofing off began. The last line was a little different. Controlling the rope, the guide stopped everyone halfway across the line to dangle over a 250-foot drop, leading to a breathtaking waterfall. After the zipline, it was time to cool off, and that picturesque falls was the place to be.
Ooh, yeah, hey. Come on. Come on, yeah.
Nearing the end of the trip, playing in the waterfall gave the crew time to reflect on the good times that they had. In all accounts, the Panamanian adventure was a success. Quality waves, friendly people, and joyful vibes followed the crew wherever they went. And knowing they only scratched the surface of what Panama has to offer, another trip is definitely in the future. For more info on traveling to Panama, check out visitpanama.com. With tons to offer both in and out of the water, Panama has something for everyone.
Still amazes me when I look down at a cakey.